Welcome to the Ayala Art channel. This is your artsy friend, Martha. If you like art journaling, acrylic techniques, art challenges, and art collaborations, this is your channel. Hello, everyone. I am going to be using a lot of washi tape in this collaboration with Shae206. It's going to be a lot of fun to play with these gorgeous little sticky things. Anyway, I have a bunch of designs and I'm going to be just putting them all over the place, mostly over here because I want to close these little holes over here for the page. But everywhere else, because they're just so much fun to see. And some of it will be covered. Shae can just do whatever she wants with this background. I do not expect anything to be showing. It will be just up to her. I am just going to be working on this, and I'm going to be using pastel colors, more or less what I have in the washi tape, which is a lot of fun springy colors in different greens, aquas, purples, yellow. So let's see what happens with this group of yummy colors. And I'm going to speed the video. So if this is the first time that you visit my channel, I hope you click over here and subscribe. If you click the little bell, you will get notifications every time I upload, which is weekly on Tuesdays. And when I am doing a challenge or some other video thing, I will upload more times during the week. But anyway, this is going to be so much fun. I hope you enjoy it. Now I want to make a note. I have colors that are secondary and complementary, and since they are already pre-mixed, the color is already made in the bottle, chances are I'm going to get some muddy brown or some strange gray. So what I'm doing is I pour a lot of water with my sprayer, and I am not going to exactly mix the colors. I'm going to just allow the little color, especially like this purple with the green and other tones similar like that. I'm just going to leave them for later so I do not overwhelm the two colors together. I go from one to the other one, but leaving space if it makes sense. So if I start grabbing right now the yellow, I will just go and leave the yellow dominate instead of mixing equal amounts of the purple, the yellow, or the green and the purple, or the aqua, you know what I mean? Just let one color be the dominant in your brush work so you don't end up with the color mixed, the two colors mixed together and making a brown, because what I want here is luminosity and a lot of fun colors. So have a napkin ready. And you can just clean your brush or use another brush for certain other areas, like if I want to continue over here and I don't get them so close together. They are together, but not all together, if it makes any sense. Some colors do play together very nicely, but others need their space. Okay. At this point, I'm going to get a napkin. You can just clean your brush and keep going. let the napkin be the one that ends up with the strange mix. And you don't worry about it. Okay, I want to put some turquoise over here. So anyway, this is just a very quick way to start a page so you don't have to be starting from nothing. There's texture, there's a lot of color, there is somewhat of a composition, a little rhythm over here going to this way or the other. If you want to just continue going all in one direction, you don't have to. You can just do some things knowing that you're not mixing the colors exactly. What I want right now is wait for this to dry, and then I will come back and add a sparkle, maybe some either glitter or metallics, maybe some gold, and maybe a little bit more of my washi tape somewhere in there, wherever I see that I want more of the similar color. And I don't have to even go again how I started with this direction. I can just put one over here and whatever, you know. This is just covering the ground, so you have the beginnings of a background to start from there and do whatever you want to do in your canvas, in your paper, in your journal page, whatever the substrate. You just don't be afraid of the white. This is basically what I'm trying to say. Okay, I'm going to wait for this to dry and I'll come back. This is dry and I found my magic fork. Yay! I'm going to apply a little bit of clear gesso and I'm going to make some little shapes with my fork. I decided not to add more of the washi tape because the paint left enough texture that is not going to sit completely flat, but I have enough little I have to glue this one again. I have enough showing through here and there that I'm happy with it. Okay, and then I'm going to be making a couple of little circles with something. I'm not sure what. Probably maybe black, just to be completely popping out. And I have another little tiny container to make another size of circles. So I'm just going to plaster them here and there. I don't have really a plan. I'm just going to go and leave this busy enough that whatever she does is going to, you know, have a lot of chances to bring some creativity, if nothing else. So I am just going to go, I'm just going to go and play with this. Okay, now I'm going to wait for this to dry. It's going to dry completely transparent and it's just going to leave just these squiggly lines in a way that when you paint over them, it's going to be a hit and miss for the next color. After this dries, I'm going to come back with my little stamping circles and see what else I can just put in there just for fun. Okay, I think this is all I want, and probably a little glitter wouldn't hurt. So I'm going to get a clean brush and I'm going to put it again in this one with the silver. I was just going to do the brush, but I think I want the circle. So I'm going to just, ooh, it looks very pretty. Like that. And I'm going to just add a little bit more because it looks so pretty. And I don't have to do the whole circle. I'm just going to do like a half circle over here. There. Now, if you remember, I have all of this other texture with the little wavy lines. So it is just going to be very interesting to see what happens to it. There is no right side, so it can be just take interpreted or worked from any angle. I'm going to get the camera close so you can see in case that the glitter or the silver is not showing so well in the distance. I hope you have fun watching this video. I'm going to include a card so you see what Shae does with this painting and what I'm getting on the mail from her and what I'm going to be painting. So don't miss the playlist. If you have not subscribed to my channel, click down there to subscribe. Also click, if you want, on the bell so you will get notifications every time I upload a new video. See all that glitter? Woo! Give us a thumbs up if you like this video and remember to keep your paintbrush wet.